Today we'll be creating a simple movement script in Unity. This can be applied to any game or project that you make. It is easy for beginners. First, we'll start by creating a new Unity project. Make it 3D. I'll name my project Tutorial. Welcome to the Unity interface. In the middle of the Unity interface, you'll see the scene, which has all your components of your game. Then, on the left is the hierarchy, which shows you all your objects. There's now also the game window, which will show you the final output of your game. We'll create a 3D object and make it a capsule. I'll name this player. And you can see in the scene, we can move this around however we want. I'll just move it a little up. Now we will add a component. We'll add rigid body. Make sure it is rigid body, not rigid body 2D, because we are in 3D. Now let's run this. You'll see if we run, it'll go to the game window and the capsule will fall through. The reason is rigid body adds gravity. Now we'll create a cube. This will be a floor so that the capsule does not fall through. We're going to be using the capsule as our player for this project. I can just make it a little bigger in this window by using the resize tool. But in the transform, I can also change the scale to make it bigger much faster. I'll make it pretty big so that we have a lot of space to move around. Now you see it doesn't fall through. Now we will create a material. A material is like a color, and it can color any of our objects in the scene window and in the game window. I'll make this color red for the player, so it stands out. And you see, we just drag it and it's not red. Now, we can create another material. This material will be for the floor. So I'll make it green, like grass. Now we just drag that. And perfect. Now we have our little games going and we can start coding. Just test this in the game window, and now we can start coding. So we're going to be applying a script to the player object, and this will be the main script for movement. We'll go to the player, and then we'll create a script. I'll also name the cube floor, just so we know what it is. Now we can go to the player and script and create a script. I'll show you how to do this in a second. Okay, so we go to the player and we're going to add a component, just like we did for the rigid body. Okay, but this time it's not going to be a built-in component. We'll type in movement script. What this will do is, because there's no script that's already built in, it'll ask us to make a new script, and here we can code. Okay, we have our first script. Let's just wait for it to load. Okay, and our script is opening. Okay, so welcome to coding in Unity. I'm going to be using Visual Studio to code. When we create our coding script, you can see that we'll have two classes that are already there. Void start and void update. These are the two main classes in our scripts. Void start is what happens at the exact start of when we hit the play button. See? So when we're hitting the play button, when you hit the play button, it will execute whatever's in void start. Void Update, however, will keep running during the entire game. So once we press the play button, it'll still keep running. We're going to be mainly using Void Update. Okay, now we can start coding, now that we know the basics. First of all, we will not be using the void start much. We'll be mainly using the void update script. But just keep the void start there for now. Okay, we're gonna start by creating a float. A float is like it's a number, but it has a decimal. So first, we'll create public float speed, and we'll set it to 3.5. Remember, when we do floats, we always have to put an F at the end. And another rule is to put a semicolon at the end for everything you do. Okay, now that we've made this float, we can start coding. So we'll put an if statement, and we'll say that if input.get key, input.getKey, and then we're gonna put right key, which is like the right arrow key. We want to say what we're gonna do for that. So now we're gonna create our brackets, and this will be whatever to execute. So we'll put transform dot position, and then we are going to do plus equals vector 3 dot right, and then times speed so that it moves by the amount of speed, and time dot delta time. Now this will be similar for all our other movement keys, but we might have to change a little bit. Now remember, we have to put the semicolon at the end. Okay. Let's go to our thing and see, we have an error. This is because we didn't put a semicolon. I'll just go and fix this quickly. Okay, now it should be working fine when we move the right key. Let's just quickly make movement for the left key so that we can test more. Now this is going to be very similar, but instead of transform.position plus equals, it's going to be minus equals. We'll save our work and we'll test this out. Okay, you see that we can move left and right flawlessly. Our code is working. Okay. Now you see in the game mode, we can do this. Now, we are going to cover jumping. Jumping will be a little different. I'll just test this one more time before we try jumping. Because you see, if we cannot jump right now, and this, it might seem that we can just do vector 3 dot up, but that won't work. And also, for input dot get key left, instead of doing transform dot position minus equal, we can do vector 3 dot left. Now let's work on jumping. Okay, let's put space as our key. Now this will actually be very different from the right key and the left key. We're going to have a different code to be able to jump. Okay, so right now, this we can delete. And then we're going to go to our rigid body, and this we are going to use in this code. So let's create another flow, and we'll name this jump force, or J force, I'll name it. And I'll put it test 10F. This is the amount of force that will fight the gravity of rigid body. And now we'll do get component, because we're getting the component rigid body, because rigid body has everything to do with physics, so we'll also have to do with jumping. Okay, so we'll get component rigid body, and then we are going to add force, and then we can use 0, 10, and instead of 10, we're actually going to be using jumping force, because jumping force does equal 10. Now you see what this does? It's the actual coordinates x, y, and z. So if we're adding j force to y, it's gonna make us jump. Now let's see how this is working. Okay, we can jump pretty high now. See, okay, we can move, we can jump. So our code is working pretty well. And now there's one thing we're going to want to do. We're going to do camera follow, which is we're going to put the main camera as a child of player. And now you see, we can actually see the player moving and jumping in 3D. This looks pretty cool. Now, and it fell. Yeah, it can tilt too. And we can still jump. Oh, we can jump pretty high. Now there's a lot more you can do with this. You can add more your controls with like forward movement and using left keys and arrow keys as thing. But that's all for this video. Bye.